Hey y'all, and happy Thanksgiving. For this video, it's a tire video. We're going to be looking at the Toyo CT tires and RT tires, giving you a tread life update, talking about what kind of off-road traction and different elements they have, and road noise. Go over those three categories. And we have the Toyo CTs here today, and these have been very impressive in the tread life category. Later in the video, I'm going to address tread life, how my truck gets good tread life, other people's don't get good tread life. You know, what's my situation? What's my secret to good tread life? These tires have 67,000 miles on them. I put them on, like at 343K, something like that. And now the truck has 410K on it. So I'm thinking that's 67,000. And the tread is mostly still there. It's really impressive. A lot of tires would be long gone by 67K, and these are holding up quite well. They might only be halfway through their life. Tread is wearing fairly evenly. There is a bit of a chop on the inner tread blocks. Like here's a lower one and a higher one and a little bit lower one, but that's kind of minor. Over the course of 67K, I would expect to see a little bit of chopping going on, especially on these trucks. This truck has a pretty good front end, but especially on tires that are more aggressive. My MTs chopped worse than this. These are actually wearing better than the MTs did on the chopping situation. Tread life has just been tremendous. This will probably set the record for me for most tread life I've ever got out of a set of tires. How about the traction? Traction is good. It's not as good as the MTs in mud. The MTs have a grippier tread pattern on the middle blocks especially. These are still blocky. The blocks are closer together than on the MT tires. And they don't dig as much. They're actually better for flotation, so they've done better in the sand for me. And they're also a snowflake. Let's see, where is our snowflake? There you go. A snowflake tire, and I've had them in the snow. So since the last video, I did do a snow drive in these up north, and in the snow they do quite fine, but they're better on pavement than off-road in the snow. Off-road, my situation was a bit rough with these. The snow was about 6 inches deep. It was on a incline, trying to get up the incline. They did not make it up the hill off-road in a cornfield, but the snow had melted and refrozen, so it was very icy. I don't think any tire would have done very well in that situation, and so there was a little bit to be desired in that snow situation, but they do hold their own in the snow. Laterally, when you're steering in snow, these have good traction. The MTs, you might be sliding a little bit. They have a lot more siping on the tires than the MTs do. And they also have holes for studs. So for snow, these are a good option. These are the rear tires here, which look to be in pretty good shape. I mean, like they have the chop on the inner treads, although not as much. I'm gonna rotate these probably tomorrow. But they look very good. I can't tell you how happy I am with the tread life on these. So we've gone through off-road already. Mud, I would rate them a 7 or 8 out of 10. Snow, I would rate them an 8 out of 10. If they've got studs on them, they'd be a 10. Sand, I would rate them an 8 out of 10. They do quite well on the sand. Gravel roads, so they're okay on gravel. And this is a fresh layer of limestone that they're on right now. And I'm not really seeing as much rocks and stuff getting stuck in these blocks, but I've had the issue of those rocks getting stuck in there, and then they'll come flying off when you go up to highway speeds, and that was always irritating, but not really seeing that problem as they've gotten older. Speaking of getting older, how's the road noise been? Because when I first put these on, they were impressively quiet, barely louder than a normal all-terrain tire. But I will say that after about 20,000 miles, the volume started kicking up. And now at 67K, probably due to the minor chopping, I would say that's probably the cause of these being almost as loud as MT tires now. They do have a noise to them at higher speeds. But once you get up to about 40, 45 miles an hour, you start hearing them. And they're still not as loud as my Toyo MTs were. And Toyo MTs are on the quieter side for MT tires. So I'm not sure that I have a lot to complain about with them. I think the volume is reasonable. So that is the Toyo CT. Overall, very happy with them. I think this is my favorite set of tires that I've purchased so far. The only thing I could say about them is I wish they made a size between this 33 and the 35. If they had like a 33 and a half or a 34 inch, I would be all over it. I would definitely go with these tires again. I'm not sure what I'll do for my next set of tires, but these seem like they're gonna have another 60, 70,000 miles left in them. So let's move on to the Toyo RT tires. So here we are with the Toyo RT tires. Not nearly as many miles on these, a little over 14,000 miles. Let's take a look at the tread wear. Wearing evenly, not really seeing much of a chop yet. There was like an extra layer, you can kind of see it. There's a little edge here. There was like an extra level to all the tread blocks. It's basically worn down flush with that on these tires, meaning that I would say there's a fair amount of life left in them. I mean, these could see 60 or 70K miles. And I think this truck could use some adjustment to its alignment because it is wearing a little bit faster out here versus in there. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe we go with a zero toe on the next alignment instead of a toe in. I'm not sure yet to think about it, but I'm gonna take it for an alignment soon. Now, as far as, so tread life has been good. I project these tires to have good tread life, although not as good as the other truck, but I think that's more about the truck than the tires. I think if these tires were on that truck, they would have similar tread life as the CTs, although they might be a bit softer rubber than the CTs. Which kind of surprises me. Usually soft rubber is what you would have on a winter snow tire, but with the CTs, they're commercial tires and they're wearing very slowly. So I'm thinking it's a harder rubber. Now on these, they're not snowflake rated and they don't have as much siping. I mean, no siping on these tread blocks here. One large sipe on the outside, one in the middle, and another one on the outside. Not as much siping, but they do fine in the rain. The CTs over there do fine in the rain as well. In the mud, I would give these about a 7 out of 10. They're not full-blown mud tires, but they do have blocky outer blocks, which are similar to a mud terrain. A slight scallop right here for a little bit of grip. The sidewall isn't quite as grippy or aggressive as what I had on the MTs, and even the CTs are a little bit more aggressive on the sidewall. I don't mind that sidewall, but they could have made it better for this tire. Could have been better. The Nitto Ridge Grapplers have a more aggressive sidewall. Noise-wise, these have been quite quiet. I'm gonna get back to the elements here in a minute. Let's talk about noise. Noise, they've been very quiet, barely louder than all-terrain, but they're still early in their life. I'd like to see how these do 10,000 miles from now, if they're any louder or not. So we did mud at 7 out of 10. Snow, I haven't driven them in the snow. Sand, 7 out of 10. They're pretty good in the sand. They have decent flotation, but they're not as good as the Toyo CT, I wouldn't say. That's really all I got to say about these. That's the update on the RT. Very happy with these tires. They do offer a lot more tire sizes than the CT. This one is a 33.5 by 12. Yeah. 33.5 by 12. Love this tire size. I wish they made the CT in this tire size. So that is the update on the RT tires. So for the final section of this video, it's going to be a little bit of a response to a few comments that I've gotten on past videos, especially the Toyo CT video where I hit 50,000 miles and showed how they were doing. A lot of people said their tires, they got the same tires, they look nothing like that, not nearly as good. You know, they've got half the tread with 10,000 less miles on them or something like that. So basically my tires are pretty optimistic on the tread life compared to what some of the commenters are getting. So what's the key to success? I know things have changed for me on the same truck since I've owned it, based on how I'm driving, where I'm driving, and the condition that the front end is in. I think that's what it comes down to. What type of driving you do, the condition of your front suspension, and just what you're doing with the truck. So let's start with condition of the front suspension. Replacing the ball joints and the shocks did a lot for tires on that truck. The chop significantly reduced the chop, and the overall tread wear was significantly less after putting a set of shocks and ball joints on there. The next thing that I did, so there was two sets of tires that were the same tires. I had a set of Toyo MTs. They were a little bit different on the size, but same type of tire. And the first set only lasted 63,000 miles. Now that's pretty good mileage, fairly average for what those tires get. But they were like drag slicks at that point. My second set lasted 100,000 miles, and they were only just starting to get to the wear indicators. I could have pushed those another 5,000 to 10,000 miles. The only reason I swapped them out, I was encouraged to swap them out, because one tire would not stop leaking. It had a leak, and I was filling it with air every few days, and that was really getting annoying. And I'm like, rather than have them patch this leak for just 5,000 or 10,000 miles, I'll just get my next set of tires. And I was excited about trying the Toyo CTs out anyways. So that's the story. What happened between the first set of tires and the second set? Well, one was near the end of the life of the first set of tires, I put new shocks and ball joints on. Also replaced the steering linkage, did front axle wheel bearings, rebuilt the whole front end, even U-joints, front axle U-joints and front hubs, wheel bearing assemblies. Pretty much a front end rebuild, new sway bar end links, all that stuff might help a little bit, but shocks and ball joints are the big one. The next thing that happened was I started driving on more favorable roads for tread wear. Flat, straight roads. I moved from up north to down south. No more, you know, up north it snows. The plows come, they chew the roads up. There's potholes everywhere as a result. And I lived where there was windy roads and hilly terrain, and I was slamming the brakes, headed down steep grades, or accelerating heavy to go up from a stop to go up a grade. All that kind of stop and start driving and things like that, put some wear on your tires. Having bad roads, windy roads, things like that, there's lots of hazards on the roads up there. So more tread wear. So where I live now, it's like I cruise on the interstate. I rarely have to accelerate or decelerate. I'm just cruising most of the time. And that truck also has had the benefit, the white one, has had the benefit of being retired from towing duties pretty much. I do all the towing with this one. So that truck's just driving around with no trailer. If you've got a heavy trailer on, your tread life will be shorter, because you're just gonna have, you know, there's gonna be more friction over those rear tires at least. You'll see more tread wear on your rear tires with trailer towing. Whereas if you're running around unloaded, it's gonna be the front tires that are gonna wear the fastest. So that's kind of been what happened. That's why I got 100,000 miles out of a set of mud terrain tires on that truck. But even still, doing research, that was like unheard of. I haven't seen anyone else come close to that. So however the alignment is on that truck too, the alignment's important. If you have a bad alignment, like this one may need a little bit of some alignment work to get these outer tread blocks to wear the same rate as the inner. I can definitely tell a difference here. You know, over the course of 14,000 miles, it may be 1 millimeter, maybe 1.5 millimeters. Like it's not drastic, but over the course of 50,000 miles, these treads might actually end up bald out here with significant tread left in here. So alignment is important too. So alignment, front end, how you drive the truck. So a lot of it's out of your control, but how you drive the truck and the kind of roads you drive on, that all has a significant impact on your tread life. So this piece of the video is just to clarify what my situation is and how I've found success with tread life on tires. And it's a good thing
because tires are very expensive. Anyways, once again, happy Thanksgiving. Hope you all have a great weekend. I'll see you in the next video.